Texas Instruments' new TCAN4550-Q1 evaluation module is a general purpose board to evaluate the TCAN4550-Q1 SBI to CAN-FD controller with integrated transceiver in a wide variety of automotive and industrial applications. The supply voltage and CAN-FD bus signals are available on an industry standard DB9 connector, allowing for easy integration into test fixtures and wiring harnesses. Power can also be supplied to header J9 before the filtering, polarity, and transient protection components, or directly to the TCAN4550 VSUP supply rail on header J8. A dual-channel LDO creates a 5-volt rail to supply non-critical components such as LEDs and a selectable VIO voltage to set the digital IO levels through DIP switch S1. The EVM supports 5 volts and 3.3 volt VIO levels with additional support for 2.5 volt and 1.8 volt VIO levels for future implementations. The LDO's VIO output is connected to the inhibit pin of the TCAN4550, allowing it to be disabled when the TCAN4550 is placed into sleep mode. Pressing the S2 push button or issuing a low voltage pulse on the wake low voltage pin of the digital IO header J16 will wake the TCAN4550 from sleep mode. Since wake and inhibit signals are referenced to the higher supply voltage, to avoid damage, these must not be connected directly to a low voltage MCU. Inhibit can be monitored by a MCU on the inhibit low voltage pin of J16 with direct control of the VIO LDO output possible through the LDO enable low voltage pin of J16. The high voltage wake and inhibit signals are directly available on header J4. LDO control features are available on header J2, and the 5 volt and VIO voltages available on headers J1 and J3. VCC out, TCAN4550's internal LDO output voltage is available on header J6. LEDs have been placed on the digital signals and can be disconnected through DIP switch S4. The TCAN4550 can be reset through the reset pin of J16 or manually through push button S3. A 40 MHz crystal is used as the default clock source for the TCAN4550, but an external clock can be supplied on SMA J5 after moving resistors R30 and R32 to R34 and R35. Future support of an output clock is also included on the clock out SMA J7. The EVM has several bus connections available. The bus can be configured to support a common mode choke after removing R3 and R45. 120-ohm split termination is connected through shunts on J11 and J14. Optional TVS diodes can be installed on D12, and transient voltage injection or monitoring through header J13. A signal ground plane under the CAN bus allows a DC voltage offset to be applied to the CAN signal reference. If no offset is desired, the signal ground and ground planes should be shorted together with a shunt on header J15. For additional information on the TCAN4550 EVM, please visit the link below. Thank you for watching.